Repository imports in Alma. Alma allows you to import bibliographic records to create physical and electronic inventory. There are a number of reasons you may have for wanting to import a file of MARC records into Alma. You may receive files with the MARC records from vendors when you are placing orders, or you may work with a cataloging service that provides bibliographic data that you would like to load into your catalog. During this import, Alma can check to see if the MARC and XML is valid, it can apply normalization rules to transform the data, and it can also match the records in the files to existing records in the catalog and import, overlay, or merge them. The first step in loading records into Alma is defining the import profile. To create, edit, copy, or delete import profiles, you must either have the catalog administrator or the acquisitions administrator roles assigned to your user. Let's see how to set up an import profile. I'll go to Resources, Import, Manage Import Profiles. Click Add New Profile. Next, I'll choose the import profile type. There are several profile types to choose from. If you're working with bib records that include purchase and ordering information, you would use either the New Order or Update Inventory profile types. Authority and Initial Authority profile types allow you to create and update authority records. Then there is the Digital profile type for local or remote digital records, and a Collections Import profile type used to create top-level collections and their subcollections. In this example, we'll be using the Repository Import profile type. This is used for creating bibliographic records and creating physical inventory. I'll enter a profile name and choose the originating system. I'll ensure that the source formats and encoding are correct. In this case, I'm working with MARC 21 bibliographic XML data. I'll click Next. And now I can filter and normalize the records if needed. Filtering determines the records that will be left out during the import. For example, I might want to leave out any records without an ISBN or ISSN. And normalization allows us to make changes to the data as it's being imported. For example, I could delete the data in the 952, or I could even write my own normalization rules and apply them here. Let's click Next. Here I can determine how I want to match records in the file with existing records in the catalog. I may want to match records based on their identifiers. I can also define what happens when the records are matched. Do I want to handle them automatically or manually? Do I want to merge or do I want to overlay matching records? Or do I want to leave them out of the import? Or do I want to import the new record anyway? There are additional parameters you can define on this page that further refine how matched records are dealt with. Please see the Ex Libris Knowledge Center for documentation with more detailed information. Let's click Next again, and we're brought to the parameters for setting management tags. This is where we can choose to suppress records from publishing and synchronize records with OCLC and Libraries Australia. Let's click Next a final time. In the last screen of the wizard, we can choose to add inventory items and determine if they will be electronic, mixed, or physical items. Because Alma can't tell what should be created based on the file alone, Alma will create the inventory types based on what you enter here. Now I click Save to save my profile, and it's here in my list. For additional information regarding import profiles, please see the Ex Libris Knowledge Center. Thank you for watching.